and by the SEBI from trading for a year. We have Shankar Sharma now joining us here on the channel to quickly take you through some of those news points. But first, of course, Mr. Sharma, appreciate it. Appreciate your coming in and speaking to us. Would like to firstly figure out, how do you plan to challenge this decision, and do you contend the charges of involvement in synchronized trading?
I mean, look, first of all, this and we, in fact, participated in the inquiry on these charges, and SEBI's own inquiry itself exonerated us. That is the strangest thing, even back then. And now after 8 years, I don't know on the exactly the same transactions, how somebody can file somebody guilty when after, 8 years back, the exact same transactions we were found to be okay. That is point number one. Point number two is that this order has anyway been stayed in advance by the Bombay High Court, so it doesn't have any legal bearing or legal existence as of right now. We will be obviously going to SAT, and we'll be showing them that on these transactions we've already, exonerated in 2001. So this order has to be struck down immediately. And there is no question the order will go, as a lot of SEBI orders have gone in the past, and they will go in the future. This one will also go.
So just to clarify then, you're saying that you have already seeked a stay before this decision becomes effective, if at all it can become effective?
It is not effective. This order has been already stayed by Bombay High Court in advance. We got an advance stay on all SEBI orders from Bombay High Court nearly 4 years back. We were fearing that they would keep doing, one malafide act after another. So the Bombay High Court was kind enough to grant us an advance stay. So, this order is covered by that advance stay. So this order has no legal bearing.
Shankar, I'll request you to give me a little bit of rope on this one. Some quarters, there's been a little bit of buzz that perhaps now that the SEBI found nothing against your company, they're sort of going after you. Would you say that's valid?
Well, absolutely. Exactly. That is exactly, what it is. But the fact of the matter is that thankfully we have protection from the Bombay High Court. So even that, in that design also, SEBI will not succeed. And insofar as your other question was on the charge of synchronized trading, if you just look at the stocks that you're talking about, you're just talking Reliance Industries, Wipro, Zee Telefilms, stocks that are the most liquid end of the market, and their 5,000 share transactions, you're calling synchronized and calling it, that will affect the price of Zee and Reliance Industries. Then I have no more things to say about, the understanding of this regulator about the, stock markets. It's too absurd to even begin to talk about. These are not Z Group stocks. These are stocks with market caps of $20 and $100 billion. It's too absurd to even begin talking about it. And that too, 5,000 shares and, 8,000 shares.
Shankar, so you're clearly not extremely worried about this then, but would you say that just given, when such announcements come out, it of course causes a bit of a flutter. Will this affect your business in any way?
No, it will have no effect on our business whatsoever. Everybody knows what the truth of the matter has been, and not just today, for the last eight years. The people of this country, they know exactly what I actually stand for and what First Global as a firm stands for, and which is always to think of investors first. So, people know what the reality is, so this will have absolutely no effect. In any case, the order itself doesn't come into force. And for First Global itself, the business continues. And as far as my personal role is concerned, I will continue to be exactly what I am right now, because the order does not have any legal bearing, since the Bombay High Court has already stated it.